And we're here with Henry Jackson at the weigh-in in Las Vegas, the Mr. Olympia amateur. Henry, now I understand that you're the winner of the Junior USAs back in 2016.
Yeah, Junior USAs 2016. Pretty stiff competition there. I did a 12-week prep, did my own prep, and came out with the victory. Weighed in at 255, between 250, 255 last year. I was just 262 just now, just to give everybody an update because I know everybody will ask. But yeah, I'm ready to get started.
So gained about 10, 12 pounds there.
Yeah, and also I'm a lot leaner, a lot drier this go around. So maybe, you know, could have been anywhere between 15 pounds or so.
Your age?
I'm 27.
27 years old, this monster juggernaut coming out of what area of the country?
Columbus, Georgia, East Coast.
Columbus, Georgia, and you guys were just impacted a little bit by that hurricane, right?
Yeah. Surprisingly, we made it out in the nick of time. Well, the storm passed, so storm hit Monday. We were kind of nervous about the flight Tuesday.
Right.
But then everything ended up clearing up, so we got up here, no problems.
Okay, and your expectations?
Expectations, man. I'm hoping to do well, hoping to get the pro card, get the pro victory. But we'll see. I just going to give it my best, give it my best shot.
What's it mean to you to be able to compete in the Mr. Olympia amateur here in Las Vegas?
Oh, man, words can't even describe, especially with this being the first one in the States.
Right.
Hopefully, you know, I can go in and make some history as the first amateur Olympia in the U.S., but we'll see, man. I know it's a lot of guys coming in, a lot of stiff competition, so I'm going to keep my head up. And
how long have you been competing?
I've been competing since 2011, but I've been training since for 13 years. I started training when I was 14 for football, and that's been doing it ever since. Quit football back in 2009 and just stumbled into my first bodybuilding show for fun in 2011. Been doing it ever since.
So. You just kind of stumbled into it. Okay, yeah. Well, a lot of those ex-football players, they're still looking to train heavy and something to do, so bodybuilding's a great alternative.
Yeah, exactly. After football, I still like love to work out, still love to lift, and just did a show for fun in my college hometown, and I loved it, so decided I was going to turn pro. And
gotten bitten by the iron bug.
Yeah, I did, so been doing it ever since, man.
Okay. Do you have any special shout-outs for your folks back in Georgia and the Southeast?
Ooh, so many people. First and foremost, my girlfriend who is here with me right now. Oh, man, you know how it is dealing with bodybuilders during prep. Irritability is high. My coach, Phil Vizzacaro, the Ucos, my girlfriend's family for helping me out on this trip as well. Her parents, my parents, Clean Eats. Yeah, she's coached me along. There's so many people I shout out. Clean Eats, everybody in Columbus, Mary at Body Evolution, my friend Anthony, Jeff. Man, just so many people. If I'm forgetting anybody, just know, thank anybody who helped me any shape, form, or fashion along this way. They say bodybuilding is an individual sport, but obviously, yeah, you need a good team behind you. So just thank you to everyone. I know I probably forgot some people, but.
It happens. Where can people follow you at on social media?
Facebook is my first and last name, Henry Jackson III. Instagram is Henjacked. It's HenJacked. So first three letters of my first name, Jack, and ED, Jacked.
Well, that's Henry Jacked. Hopefully he'll be all jacked up on the stage tomorrow. Don't miss it. Exclusive coverage with MDLatino.com in Spanish, English, Portuguese. Here we got the big American from Georgia coming in to over 100 kilos, super duper heavyweight, Henry Jacked. Hasta la próxima. Nunca te des por vencido. Ciao. And we're here with Nick Natt at the Mr. Olympia Amateur in Las Vegas. Nick, you're from Denver originally, right?
Denver, Colorado, that is correct.
Okay, tell us a little bit about your amateur career here in the United States.
So the amateur career has been a fantastic one. I started competing around 2012.
Okay.
It started off in men's physique, and then it slowly moved into classic physique. I suffered a knee injury, and so I moved back into men's physique, but just happy to be competing in general, and eventually I'd like to be able to make my staple in the classic men's physique division.
So you're going to do the classic physique tomorrow?
I will actually be in men's physique tomorrow.
Be in men's physique tomorrow. Could go either way. Wasn't sure.
Either way.
Yeah. Okay, and definitely. So you're jumping back between categories here. You know, that's obviously part of what's happening in the league right now, especially the amateurs. They feel like they're going to give it a shot in men's physique, maybe classic physique, going back and forth.
Absolutely. You know, with the both divisions being fairly new, obviously we have a little bit of track record with men's physique, but classic physique still being in its early stages. Athletes are really sort of trying to figure out what it is that the judges want, and then also from year to year or even month to month, figuring out what it is that they're calling. And so I think it's going to take some time for there to be a little bit more of a consistency between the look, and then once people find out what's kind of their best fit, like myself, they'll find a home.
Especially in the classic physique, because I know you're a taller guy, and they just changed basically the norms and regulations for different weight classes and heights and stuff like that for classic physique. So people are still trying to figure out that mold.
Absolutely. I think when I had started, my weight was to be around 225 pounds, which is about 6'2 to 6'3.
And that could easily be bodybuilding right there. I mean,
absolutely. That's bodybuilding. And I think they actually leveled it up. I would be mistaken. But, you know, you're given about another 5 to 10 pounds. And believe it or not, that can make a huge difference in the shape of a physique, depending on the athlete and the aesthetics that they're bringing to the table. So it makes it exciting. Different playing cards.
We're over there in Denver, Colorado with Alexander Carnero, Phil Heath, definitely a growing vibe in the bodybuilding trend out there. What do you train at?
I actually own a gym. It's called Rocky Mountain Flex Fitness. We're just south of the downtown Denver area. And again, just very happy to be making the staple, representing Denver, Colorado with so many remarkable NPC, but also IFBB professionals. I think we do have Heather Grace, women's physique. She placed top three last year in women's physique category. So we have quite a few out here representing the actual Olympia as well.
Why did you choose this event, the Mr. Olympia Amateur? Because I know as an NPC competitor, there are a lot of shows. There are a lot of national shows that you can qualify, you know, get a pro card. Do you just do this out of the morbid curiosity, or the fact it was in Las Vegas, something being a part of history, you know, a tradition?
You literally hit the nail on the head. It was such an opportunity. You know, everyone's always talked about the Arnold Amateur, but right. There's never been an Olympia Amateur held here in the States, and right. So having the opportunity to come out here, you know, I kind of stay all year round around 5 to 6 weeks body fat, just because for me that's really where I'm comfortable. I challenge myself as an athlete, and so coming out and having a chance to do something that I've never done before and being a part of history was remarkable. And I mean, again, it's during Olympia weekend. It's the biggest expo in the world. So
when did you make that decision? Like, you know, something, you know, it was released about 5 months ago, the press release for the amateur report. But when did you decide, hey, I'm going to jump in this show?
Honestly, I would say 4 weeks ago.
4 weeks ago.
4 weeks ago.
All right, cool. You know any of your rivals here from the States or internationally?
You know, I don't actually.
It's curious, right? All the physiques, the different looks, all the cultures.
I have heard that there's quite a few of the international report coming in, which I think is actually great. Yeah. But having said that, I wouldn't know.
Yeah. Well, you're definitely going to be one of the taller men's physiques. Usually I'm the taller guy in the interviews. You're like much taller than me. So that's Nick Natt, men's physique, sometimes classic bodybuilding, but he's going to be men's physique tomorrow at the Mr. Olympia Amateur and the tallest class, of course. You know how many people are in your division? Or?
You know, I didn't ask, but I would say that I think it's close to 10 in the class.
Okay.
So it'll be one of the smaller classes I've been in on a national qualifying stage, or I'm sorry, a pro qualifying stage, actually, because they're going to be giving out pro cards here, just so you guys know.
So, okay, great opportunity. That's Nick Natt. Where can people follow you on the social media?
Absolutely. I'm available at Natt Fitness. That's two T's. Natt Fitness on Facebook. And you can also find me on Instagram under NattFitness_33.
Excellent. Well, we have a slogan here. Until the next one, and never surrender. So we're going to see Spanish. 1, 2, 3. Nunca.
Nunca.
Te. Des.
Des.
Por.
Por.
Vencido.
Vencido.
Eso. Chao. Great, man.